out, RAV is equal to 60 minus RB, that is 60 minus 45, that is 15 kilonewton. So now very carefully visualize using three equilibrium conditions, sigma H, sigma V and sigma MA is equal to 0. We will able to found out the unknown parameter, that is the reactions, that is RAH, RB and RAV. Hence, this is a statically determinate beam and our problem is also solved with this three equilibrium condition. I wish you might have been understood this problem very carefully. Let us solve next numerical. Problem number 2. The given beam, yes, start with the beam. Which kind of beam is given over here? Yes, it is simply supported beam. Why? Because beam whose one end is hinge, another end is roller. This beam is simply supported beam. With the loading given to over here, point load as well as UDL. Combination of point load and UDL is given over here. And our intention is to find out the support reaction. That is here RAV, RAH and RB using three equilibrium conditions. Sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V is equal to 0 and sigma M at certain point is equal to 0. Let us start over here and solve our numerical. Simplified figure, that is the free body diagram for the support specifically. Let us solve the pitch. This is the given beam, that is the simply supported. The given loads are 20 and 10 kilonewton per meter. The length of a 1 meter, 1 meter and 3 meter. I will repeat, these directions or these arrow directions which I did over here are the assumed direction. Because these directions are the positive directions which I have assumed during my sign convention. If answers comes to be negative, means my assumed direction is wrong. You can assume vice versa. So now, first equilibrium condition, sigma H is equal to 0. This reaction comes to be 0 as there is not a single force which is of a horizontal type. If you use the sigma V is equal to 0, another equilibrium condition, then this is the vertical force, this is another vertical force, this and this are also vertical force. So it is over here, the important thing is the sign convention. So if we start from left to right, then RAV is acting upward and with our assumed sign convention, RAV is treated as positive. Minus 20, which is acting downward. This 10, which is acting also downward, but this 10 is of UDL, unit is of kilonewton per meter. I have to multiply with the length on which this UDL is acting, that is multiply by 3. Acting upward, that is of RB, is equal to 0. And we will solve this equation. We able to found out the first equation. See over here in this case. That is, RAV comes to be, RAV plus RB comes to be 50 kilonewton. That is the first equations we will achieve using the sigma V is equal to 0 equilibrium condition. So, using sigma V is equal to 0, we will able to establish a relationship between the two vertical reaction. But we are not able to found out a single reaction for a simply supported beam. So now we have to use the third equilibrium condition, that is sigma m at a is equal to 0 or sigma m at any point is equal to 0, person to person that point goes change. Let us take right now sigma A is equal to 0 for this case. Over here, please see. Sigma MA is equal to 0. We are taking the moment of all the forces over here is 0. So now, these two forces and its moment will be nullified automatically. Now 20. This 20 creates a moment in the clockwise direction. 20 into 1. Clockwise treated as positive. This another UDL. Now, let us we convert this UDL in terms of equivalent point load. Yes, recall the previous problem, what we did. We are converting this UDL in terms of the equivalent point load, that is 10 into 3, at acting at CG, that is of 3 by 2. So now, this creates also clockwise moment. So plus sign 10 into 3, that is the load, multiply by perpendicular distance from A, important over here, this point. So 1 plus 1 plus 3 by 2, that is 1 plus 1 plus 3 by 2. So this is nothing but load multiplied by perpendicular distance create a clockwise moment at A. This UDL create this clockwise moment at A. Another force remaining, that is RB. This RB creates anticlockwise moment, that is minus RB into perpendicular distance from A, that is 1 plus 1 plus 3. That is 5 is equal to 0. Now please simplify this equation, because in this equation only one term, that is RB, is unknown, only single unknown, and we can found out the answer over here. RB comes to be 25 kilonewton. Once we get the RB 25 kilonewton, we will put this value in this equation and we will able to found out the another unknown, that is RAV. That is RAV is equal to 50 minus RB, that is 50 minus 25 is equal to once again 25 kilonewton. So my dear friends, please see how it is very much easy to found out the three unknowns using three equilibrium conditions. Let us further proceed with the next numerical. Problem number 3. Yes. Which kind of beam is given to us? Definitely, simply supported beam is given to us, because at A joint, hinge is there. At B joint, roller support is there. Length is given 6 meter. So, simply supported beam having a length of 6 meter. Important thing is subjected to. Yes, remember which kind of load is given to us? UVL, uniformly varying load, because the load having a zero value over here. Maximum value over here, 10 kilonewton per meter. Uniformly varying along the length of the beam. So UVL is given to us, and our intention is to find out the support reaction using equilibrium conditions. We will simplify this figure by drawing a plotting of the free body diagram. This is the figure, and let us try to solve the numerical. Please bear me, this is a wrong moment has been given to over here. It is a figure plotting error is there, because only two reactions are there, because the given support is of hinge support. Let us solve over here. given beam is of simply supported beam 10 kilonewton per meter, length is of 6 meter, A joint, B joint. This 10 doesn't mean this is the horizontal, be careful, because it is this ordinate value means it is a vertical force. This is the way of representation. This doesn't mean it is the horizontal force, be carefully noted down this point. RA having two reactions, RAH and RAB, here only one RB. Yes, sigma H is equal to 0, forced equilibrium conditions. What is the answer for RAH? As there is no horizontal force acting in the, throughout the system, RAH comes to be 0 by putting the value sigma H is equal to 0. Next, sigma V is equal to 0, another equilibrium condition. Three forces, one is this RAV acting upward, treated as positive. This UBL which is acting downward. Now it is interesting, because what happens in case of UDL, if the given load is of UDL, let this value is of 10 kilonewton per meter, length is of 2 meters. So what we did, we found out load is equal to 10 into 2, as it is of, because this is nothing but one kind of rectangular load which has been given to you. This is nothing but rectangular, 2 meter length and value is of 10 kilonewton per meter. But here it is triangular load which is given to you, triangular load. So the total load is nothing but the area of triangle which is specifically acting at the CEG. So if I will convert this total load over here at CEG, it is nothing but half into 6 into 10. This is nothing but the total load for UVL. So if we will put over here RAV, now minus sign, why minus sign? Because this is acting downward, half into 6 into 10. This is acting upward, plus RB is equal to 0. So now using this equation, sigma V is equal to 0, we will able to found out one equation. Please see over the slide. Using sigma V is equal to 0, we will able to find out one equation. We obtain one equation, RAV plus RB is equal to 30 kilonewton. One equation is obtained. Our intention is to find out individual value of RB as well as individual value of RAV. To find out that one, we have to take a moment at a certain point. Once again repeat, let us take sigma M, A is equal to 0, summation of all the moments acting at point A is equal to 0. Let us find out over here. Sigma MA is equal to 0. We are taking the moment over here. So RH into 0, 0, RAV into 0, it is 0. This load, that is UVL, which is acting in the clockwise direction, acting at the CG. What is CG distance for triangle? What is this length and what is this length? This is 2/3 L, and what is this? 1/3 L. So sigma MA is equal to 0, then first, half into 6 into 10, it is the total load acting at the CG, created a moment. So perpendicular distance 2/3 into 6 with positive sign as the clockwise nature, minus RB into 6 is equal to 0. Y minus RB creates anticlockwise moment. Let us solve this equation because only one unknown is there, RB. So using your calculator, solve this equation and find out the value of RB. Let's see over here. So we are obtaining the value RB comes to be 20 kilonewton with this simple equation, and by substituting this value RB as a 20 kilonewton in this equation, we will easily obtain RAB as 30 minus 20, that is 10 kilonewton. There will be a question may arise that I am always taking a moment sigma MA is equal to 0. You may take at another point also. Let us take right now the same problem, and we are taking the moment at sigma MB is equal to 0, and let us be found out whether the answer is same or not. So let us take the same problem over here and we will obtain the answer. Yes, please, over here. Sigma MB is equal to 0. The figure is over here. We are taking the moment over here right now. So now, when we are taking a moment at the joint B, RAH, that is the horizontal force, that acting horizontally in the line of B. So RAH never creates any kind of moment at B. Yes, even though RAH is 0, so there is no issue. But if even though RAH having some value, even though it doesn't create any moment at B, because moment is nothing but the force multiplied by perpendicular distance, this RAH multiplied by perpendicular distance is 0. So RAH into 0 is 0, so this doesn't create any kind of moment. RAV definitely creates some moment. RAV into 6, as it creates clockwise moment plus sign. Another created moment at B, that is this one, that is of UVL, half into 6 into 10. This is load multiply by perpendicular distance is this one. Now because we are taking the moment over here,